So, I came into my sophomore year a bit like a puzzle without missing a couple pieces. See, during the freshman year, I had very much changed, but not changed in a way that had an ending. It was more of an opening of a rift, an opening of a divide, that it seemed would only get even further and apart as I came into my sophomore year. It seemed to me that there was a very large dissonance between what was taught and what I thought in my head. It seemed like I was thinking about things that were absolutely not ever going to help me in any way for the life that I had been so-called groomed to become in the future. And it became to a point where I realized that I had very much stopped working with the system entirely. I had begun to effectively procrastinate for the purpose of procrastinating just to do other things that I felt were much more necessary for the self. I left myself, I guess, and I became someone new, someone who I had never met before. And I guess that deep change unlocked something, because instead of finding any passion in any of the things that I had previously enjoyed, I instead found passion in strange subjects of pharmacological studies, and I became somewhat of a psychonautic. And I found that exploring the mind to be much more interesting than exploring any old history textbook. Instead of staying up late, I would go to sleep early and wake up late, specifically to spend as much time sleeping and dreaming. I found exploring myself to be quite interesting. I took a path that had never been traveled before. I took a path not traveled by myself. Instead of following the roads created for myself, I jumped off them. And I changed a lot. And I became a person that some would say is not happy. But I found that there is happiness on the outside of myself. Just because I wasn't exactly doing great with friends, doing great in school, I was still very much intact. I enjoyed life for what it was, and I found that there was no choices that I could make that could make life better. I had to make myself better. I realized that myself was myself out of the universe in itself. The ego grew, as it were, but not like the ego you understand, the ego of the self. And I found that to be quite powerful for myself. And as you can see, I have put just imagery or images, not as a statement of, oh, I didn't find any images, but more as a statement of I couldn't find any images that could define what I was doing, because the images that would show up are invisible, because they are images that only I could see myself. They're not things that you can see in the world, because it's really an entirely other world inside of your mind, you know. There's a world of dreams, of passions, of nightmares, of delusions, of voices. And really, it's an entire other universe that we all sometimes forget to explore as we get older. But I found myself to explore that world. That's what I'm going to do as I get older.